Hi guys, this is Varuna from TechView.me and we have in our hands the Lenovo YOGA 3 Pro. This is an absolute flagship product that was announced last week at a Lenovo specific event that happened in London. Now most of you guys already know that TechView.me broke some of the news and exciting rumors that were mostly true and were covered at the event live at our Twitter page at TechView.me. Now this is basically a high-end machine that we are dealing with here. First of all, this is an Intel-based laptop convertible. It actually has the latest 5th generation Intel Core processor called Broadwell. It is from Intel and it's one of the few devices to get that. Broadwell supposedly increases the battery by over 1 hour while giving it a better performance. We're not too sure how this plays against the Core i5 and i7. But this is definitely an industry and a region first. So without further ado, as we go through the box, there's obviously a big Intel branding on the front. A few specs to the right as we go around it, and there's nothing much specific on the back. Okay, we're gonna open this box up, and Lenovo has done some interesting ways to reveal the product. In fact, at the event, they unveiled the product by opening these flaps. And it's fairly simple. You have these magnetic flaps right in front of you. And as you move them away from you, you get the product risen up. Magnetic flaps here, you're gonna flip them over. And as you can see, the device itself comes up to reveal itself. So this is the device itself, completely sealed, and it's a first look for us as well. There is obviously a plastic cover on it, and it's actually very, very light in comparison with the box. There's a silver-like finish at the front, and that's the version we have. There is an orange as well as a champagne version that you can get. As you go to the back, fairly minimalistic, the color is all around, it's fairly solid. We're gonna open the wrapper and get a more better look at it, but in short, it's a very light performing laptop. Now the rest of the box on all the weight is basically two separate compartments. To the left you have where the manual stays, and on the right you have the charging cable. And this is fairly interesting. The charging adapter is small. The connector flaps up, which is very nice, and is actually powering itself from a USB port connected to the YOGA 3 Pro. Really surprised and really happy that there's a USB way of charging this laptop. Obviously you need the adapter, but a cable is always ready for you wherever you are. And that's the cable that bundles with it. It's a very long cable. It's a slightly different extension of a USB. The paperwork is actually quite useful. You have a list of all the countries where you can get international warranty and a few ways to set up and basic blueprints of the device itself. And that's about it from the box. You have the charging cables like here, the adapters, and the manuals and international warranty information. And that's pretty much it on the box. It's the box itself is actually very, very heavy. And if you go back to the tablet, and you'll get to see more on the tablet than the box. So that's the YOGA 3 Pro from Lenovo, and we're gonna quickly take off the plastic wrapper to unveil and to get a better feel of the product. So obviously the YOGA 3 Pro, fairly slim at this point, really comfortable to hold in one hand. And the finish is fairly. I wouldn't say metallic, it's slight, it feels like plastic, but it's not, it's more of a magnesium body, something like the Surface 3 Pro. You have these vents at the back of the product. Obviously Windows 8.1 does come within the YOGA 3 Pro. Again, a very light device. These vents or these gears at the top are there to assist the convertible tablet and laptop to convert in its yoga positions. Okay, so towards the left hand side you have one big USB port, we think it's a USB 3 port, a headphone jack, and these volume rockers. You also have a button for rotation lock, which is kind of interesting and useful, I would assume. And you also have a power button to power on and sleep the device. Now, at the front of the device, it's completely plain. There's nothing really going about it. It's where you open the and rotate the tablet. Very minimalistic and not really much to complain about. Towards the left-hand side, you have where the charging USB goes in. You have an additional USB port, and you also have a micro HDMI along with a full-fledged SD card slot. Again, really slim device. It's, I have to emphasize, this is how it looks when it's closed. We haven't even opened it yet. A few things that Lenovo has done: there is no Ethernet port like all the other Yoga products, and they're keeping it very bare minimum here. Traditionally, this does open up in a laptop fashion, and it can extend to that. For now, there is a protective cover covering the keyboard. Let's get rid of that for now. And there you have the very unique Lenovo Shield styled keys that we know. A really interesting part about the tablet that I didn't expect is the palm rest and the area between the keypads and the touchpad area is actually rubberized, and it's not in a cheap way. It actually is a very premium feel to it. One of the things I suspect is a lot of laptops get the smudges from your palm rest, but this might not get that. Again, the Shield keys and full-fledged keyboard with the full and big trackpad is definitely a plus for people using this primarily in a laptop fashion. The screen is fairly big. It's an end-to-end glass screen. The device closes perfectly, but does require you to use both hands to open it. Fairly small but annoying thing about a very light tablet like this. As you can see, I'm putting this Yoga 3 Pro in a completely flat 180 degree position right now. It goes completely flat, and it just shows, as you can see, how thin the product is. There's a slight wobble to the edges, but that's not really a big annoyance in my opinion. But you do understand, make sure you do realize that this is fairly sturdy. At the same time, it does flex a bit. Now, what we're going to do right now is we're going to sort of flex the screen as well as the keypad and where all the internals stay, so you get a better understanding on how the product is sturdy. Now we can flip this all the way back, and you'll get a better view of how thin and fairly light, I must assure you, that the Yoga 3 Pro is. And this is using the latest Ultra Core processors, the Intel M. The idea is you can turn back the display to completely make it in a tablet mode. Right here, I've put in the laptop's keys at the back to make it stand out. This is the stand mode that the Yoga 3 Pro has, one of the four modes that it has. Again, a very nice metallic finish, although it does feel a little plasticky. The screen does flex a bit, but it's fairly assuring. It's not something that I know would break if I applied a little more pressure. I think it's noticeable, and I think you should know that it does flex if you put pressure in it. It's not going to break if you put a lot of pressure, but keep that in mind that it can flex and might in the future ruin a few things. You don't know how Lenovo has done some usability tests and maybe a drop test, but that's one thing you should pay attention to. The gears where all the hinges is fairly inspired by how a watch looks like, and although it has over 100 moving parts, it looks good at the same time. The typing experience in every mode has been fantastic. Lenovo has been known for its amazing keypads. Let's have a quick and closer look at the hinges itself. And as we get a shot right here, you can see how nice and complicated it looks. It's in itself a thing to focus on for us, because the device is meant to rotate along this particular focus, and it does a really good job at it. It doesn't bend, it doesn't move so much as in comparison to the tablet and the screen. It actually does a very good job no matter how you position it. So that was a really first look at the device itself. Again, a really nice rubberized feel at the keypad, good keys, really fairly big touchpad. A full, amazingly high dense screen on the top where it's just a touch screen as well. And we start this up to see how long it takes to boot up. It just logged me in and it's right there. This is probably not a cold boot, but it does load up very fast. Again, it's a flagship product from Lenovo. The touch screen does work fairly well. We can open up applications and it does everything fine. Again, the product is fairly fluid. It's a gorgeous screen. We'll put a more post on TechView.me to see how the screen compares, but we've initially really loved it so much. So that's the device. Head on to TechView.me. We'll put more information and we'll put up a review fairly soon. Thank you.